think on Firecracker, it feels like almost a sequel to Tales, to the first album. And on this album, I wanted it to be even more intimate. I wanted to feel closer to the audience with my voice.
When I'm done with thinking that I'm done with you, and when I'm done with crying, then I'm done with you.
You know, it's about the music. I write music, I record music, I try to make it sound really good. And hopefully people will like that.
Then I'm done with you. You know, everybody feels this way sometimes. Everybody feels this way.
First single off of my album Firecracker is a relationship song.
And I get so frustrated.
And when I wrote this song, I really wanted to write something that people could relate to.
You ask me for an answer.
That I could get the point across quickly,
so
that people could understand.
Up in the air, up in the air.
Because it's such a strong emotion that I wanted people to be able to feel it that way, to hear it that way.
Everybody feels this way, and I do.
I feel like relationships are the things that keep people together in the world. A lot of songs I write, even though they might be stories, some of them are personal, some of them are stories, they all, a lot of them end up being about relationships, because that's how I see the world. Falling in Love is another story. These two people in Las Vegas, they meet, they fall in love. And the song, to me, explores everything that that means. The falling in love, the sometimes not falling in love.
She wanted to be a cowboy. She was shooting down. She was tramping around. And he walked in crooked with the clear blue eyes. Nice pool at my motel. You wanna go for a swim? That night he moved in. The time between meeting and finally leaving is sometimes. The time between meeting and finally leaving is sometimes called falling in love.
And the orchestration on the song, I think, makes it more cinematic, because the story is, it's a storyline that happens. It's a cowboy song. It's musically very straightforward. And then the orchestration and the way it's arranged, that gives it the depth musically.
You say, I only hear what I want to.
I always think about, is there going to be another song like Stay? Is there another song that will like climb the charts and end up in the number one spot? That's a great thing, but that's not something that I have any control over. All I can do is write songs.
And I thought what I felt was simple, and I thought that I don't believe.
To go play in Europe and in Southeast Asia and in Canada and in all over the United States and hopefully soon Latin America. And I don't think I would have had that opportunity, at least not so quickly, had it not been for Stay. I think the Lilith Fair was a great example of how women are important as musicians. The standard was wow, who's writing the best songs? Like, who's doing the best performances? And as a musician, it was a great experience because I left there being inspired by the other performers, by Emmylou Harris and Sarah McLachlan and Indigo Girls and Joan Osborne and so many of these performers. That was like a great part of the experience for me. In love with the life you'll adore. I wrote my first song when I was like in third grade. I won an award for writing a song on piano. When I started playing my songs for other people, I started realizing, wow, these are actual songs. Like, they understand them, like they want a tape of them. They want to listen to them because it relates to their world in some way. And that's when I realized, oh, okay, I guess I'll keep writing songs, you know.
This isn't what I like to call flattery, but I know that I believe that I found what's true, that I found what's you. And truthfully, I'm finding finally, truthfully, you helped me find at last, truthfully. I'm finding out what's true. Truthfully, I'm finding out what's you.
I have to say, when I met Mark Miller, I was thrilled. I was so excited. I walked into this museum. I didn't expect there to be a museum at a vineyard. And I looked up on the wall, and there was a painting version of this really cool postcard I had bought in Amsterdam. And I looked around this room where I am now, and I couldn't believe it. There were just painting after painting of these amazing illustrations. Finally, we decided to take one of the paintings that already existed because I loved it.
I was fascinated by her, I must say. She's a charming young lady. And I was persuaded to let her pick out a picture, and then I would work with her to sort of blend that into her character.
It just seemed like, oh, what an amazing record cover.
I'm asking questions.
I think we end up getting a quality of work that I'm really proud of. You know, I think the performances are good. I love the arrangements. I love the way it sounds. I like the variety on the album.
Everybody feels this way.
No, I'm never satisfied. That's my problem. That's the reason why, you know, that's the reason why you live each day.
You don't seem angry, but I do.